a happy new year to you, and a happy new decade. I know a lot of you have travelled a long way to get here and have struggled through snow, and I also know there's a lot of very smug people from Scotland that have got through not very much snow at all to be here and are really pleased that we've moved it to Edinburgh. And I think I'm actually quite pleased given that the conditions down in the south of England, because if we'd had it down there, I don't think anybody would have made it to the policy forum today. But thank you for those that have made it, and I'm sure we'll be joined by others as we go along. One of the consequences of people arriving late is that we'll make some decisions around the workshops during the coffee period in terms of whether or not we need to do any reorganisation. So if I can ask you to come back here after coffee, then we'll just make an announcement in terms of how we're sorting the workshops out for the second session. I'm really pleased that we've only lost one of our plenary sessions this morning, but you've used her 15 minutes to finish your lunches off. So we are on time, and I hope to keep that for the rest of the policy forum. So as well as travelling a long way physically for some of you, we've also travelled quite a long way in the last decade. We've had a decade of probably the best investment in research and higher education, and certainly we'll look back on this as a decade of plenty when we go through the next decade. But just to remind people, the Hefke Improving Standards Report was published in 2001, and that's really when we started kicking off some of the issues around postgraduate education. Roberts was 2002 in terms of his recommendations. The money was announced in 2003, and the first academic year for funding was 3-4. And we finally got to full funding on Roberts in 2005/6. So we've now had 5 years of full funding of Roberts. And we've also had 5 years of the UK Grad Programme and VITAI, in that we launched UK Grad in 2003 as well. Completely coincidental with the Roberts agenda, but we were ready to use that money wisely. But as I said, the next decade is going to be looking very different. We're living with the effects of the financial crisis. We're in a period of political uncertainty with a general election coming. And we know for certain that we're going to have very severe pressures on funding inside institutions. And I think in that climate, the Roberts ring fence funding is looking increasingly vulnerable. And Ian is going to talk a little bit about vulnerabilities in terms of his presentation. But I think what we need to acknowledge is how critical that was in terms of getting us where we are now. It was in 2003 at Loughborough, at what was then called our Good Practice Workshop, but very quickly turned into the Policy Forum. There was a very strong, clear, single voice from everybody attended there that the importance of providing the Roberts funding to institutions as a single fund from the research councils. And I don't for a moment believe that if we hadn't made that decision, I don't believe for a moment we would have got to where we are now. It's been hugely successful in terms of making this agenda work and getting us to create a researcher development environment. And it definitely kick-started the whole agenda. But this agenda is about cultural change, and we're not going to be able to achieve the cultural change that we want to do through ring fencing. We're only going to achieve that if it's embedded as normal business and that it's acknowledged by everybody that research and development is just a normal way in which we do our research inside institutions. So this is very much the focus of this policy forum, sort of Edinburgh 10. And it's looking forward in terms of the next decade, in terms of where do we want to get to and what are the best ways to achieve that. I mean, the aims of the policy forum are very much around creating a platform where we can have open, honest and constructive discussions about how do we get to the place where this is an achievable, sustainable agenda. And I think there are issues for both the funders and for the institutions in terms of how do we meet those challenges. So day one, we'll be looking very much at the issues relating to future funding, the advantages and disadvantages in achieving that transition to sustainability. And we've got presentations from now a couple of HEIs about how they're looking at the sustainability agenda within their own institutions And I think you'll find that very interesting in terms of provoking thoughts for the workshops. And then we've got a very good panel session, which has got some excellent replacements on it because other people will not be able to make it. But I'm sure, we'll have some very strong views in terms of what are the issues for their particular organisations. So day two, we're very much looking at how do we move forward, irrespective of what the next decade gives us, how do we move forward and ensure that we sustain this agenda? We'll look at the challenges for both postgraduate researchers and research staff, and how to build the evidence base to show that we are making a difference in terms of training and development. So, I'd like to reaffirm why we're all here and the environment and the foundations upon which we've assumed the policy forum will work. And the first one is that we are all here, whether or not we have different views, because we believe this agenda is important, and that developing world-class research is absolutely critical to the future of our institutions and also to the future economic prosperity of the UK. From the start, and I went back to every single policy forum report and conference report that has been written during our Roberts period, we have always said that it's so important to embed this agenda. And I think that's acknowledged both from the sides of the research councils and from the sides of the institutions. And the challenge for us, and particularly in the workshops today, is how do we achieve that transformation from the ring-fence funding to sustainable funding in a way that doesn't jeopardize the progress that we've made so far and allows us to continue on the agenda. I think that transition is going to be absolutely critical in terms of how do we get to where we want to be. What this policy forum isn't about is funding. There is no way the research councils can tell us at this point how much money will be available. But we should be able to, at the end of tomorrow, have gone through what are the processes that will best help us use whatever funding is available so that we can make sure this agenda survives. And it's the process of how we get there that's going to be absolutely critical. And at this point, I'd like to hand over to Ian, who's going to talk about some of the issues from the Research Council's perspectives in terms of how do we make those changes. Thank you.